हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू ई क्लास. माई सेल्फ स्मिता टीचर. स्टूडेंट्स, ओपन यूर EVS 1 टेक्स्ट बुक, पेज नंबर 78, लेसन नंबर 16, वाटर. न्यू पॉइंट वी विल लर्न टूडे. डू यू नो, वाइल ट्रैवलिंग वी ऑफन बाय बॉटल ड्रिंकिंग वाटर. द बॉटल्स आर अवेलेबल एट प्लेसेस लाइक बस स्टैंड्स एंड रेलवे स्टेशंस. रीड द इंफॉर्मेशन अबाउट द वाटर गिवन ऑन द बॉटल एंड tell others about it too. When you have bought the bottle for drinking water, that time you have to read the information about the water given on the bottle, the date of bottling and the period for which the water can be safely used is printed on the bottle. You have to read it, and according to that you then only you have to buy. Okay. It is not only for drinking water, for medicines also you have to be careful. When you are going to buy the food items, Cadbury's, biscuits, that time also you have to see the date of packing and expiry. It is important to read this information when buying a bottle. Once you have opened it, the water should not be kept for very long. Once you have opened the bottle, water should not keep for long time. The empty bottle must be crushed and thrown into a garbage bin. Then you have to, after the use of water, bottle you have to crush and throw in garbage bin so that it cannot be reused and you don't have to reuse it. Okay. Can you tell if at some place it did not rain for a very long period of time, what will be its effect on the life of the people there? If there is no rainfall for a long period, then what will be the life of people there? They will not have the water for industrialization, agriculture purpose, even for drinking also they have to rush too much. For drinking water, they have to struggle more. Then only they will get water and full lifestyle will collapse there. Water purification project at the water works. See, we get water, municipality send us water, which is processed. Then how they process the water and where? Near water source, they process water. Projects are there, purification, water purification projects are there. They process the water and send to us, which is safe for drinking. See, here some pictures are there in that water purification processes are shown. See, in first picture, settling the water from water sources is allowed to stand in the large tank. Alum is also used to help. Alum, what is mean by alum? Alum means in Marathi we say tooti. Alum is also used to help the process of settling. See, twice or thrice if we stir the piece of alum in the water, then the soil particles settle at the bottom of the water. So alum is used to settle the soil particles. Then filtration. Second picture, it is of filtration. Water is filtered using a filtration machine. In this picture, filtration machine is there. With the help of that, we can filter the water. Oxygenation. Air and water are allowed to mix with the help of pumps. Air and water mixed with the help of pumps. This causes oxygen from the air to dissolve in water. Because of these pumps, oxygen from the air mixed in the water, which is useful. That is, this process is called as oxygenation. Fourth picture, chlorination. Chlorine is mixed in the water to kill the germs in it. Chlorine powder also we can mix, otherwise chlorination is the process in which chlorine mixed in the water to kill the germs. Then water will be safe for drinking. It is germs free water. Photographs courtesy Parvati Waterworks, PMC, Pune. See, this photograph is of Parvati Waterworks, PMC, Pune. Okay. So, these are the process or steps to purify the water. Famine means there is very less waterfall. Okay. Water evaporates continuously. That is why places where it does not rain for a long time experience a drought. Where there is very less rainfall, there is the condition of drought. At such a places, the water level falls in rivers, wells, lakes, burns and dams. Some of these may even go dry. There is very less water. There is no water for agriculture, industrialization. People have to rush too much for drinking water. Okay, they have to struggle to get drinking water. These are the conditions of famine, that is drought. The land also dries up due to evaporation. Land also dries up because there is very less rainfall. Humans and animals suffer from scarcity of water. There is no water for agriculture. This condition is called a famine. A famine is a natural disaster. Famine is natural disaster, that is drought. There is very less rainfall. Land is also dries up. Humans and animals suffer for scarcity of water. There is no water for drinking. Grain and fodder becomes scarce during a famine. There is very less rain and fodder. Fodder means the food of animals. Grain and fodder becomes scarce during a famine. Grains and fodder becomes scarce during a famine. Scarce means very less rare. Fodder means the food of animals. You may have read about a famine in our state or country or in another part of the world. People living there have to face a lot of hardship. Animals and plants in those parts also suffer. All living beings get affected because of the famine. Okay, there is very less rainfall, so there is grain and fodder become scarce. The government temporarily moves people and animals from the famine stricken areas to safe places where they can be provided with water, food, grains and fodder. Fodder camps are set up to take care of domestic animals. See, if there is a condition of famine for that area, the government temporarily moves the people and animals from famine stricken area to safe places where people and animal will get the water and food, grains and fodder. Okay, there are fodder camps also, so domestic animals can stay there and they can care of domestic animals can be taken there. What's the solution? Your class will be visiting a lake which is far away from a city. Arrangements have to be made for the day's drinking water. This visit we can't do because of COVID-19, but you can search on Google which lake is near to your Yavla city. Okay, this is your today's activity. Water management. See, in famine condition, if we will manage the water properly, then we can overcome the conditions of famine. So we will see how we can manage the water. Rain brings us water again and again, but we get rain for only 4 months in a year. If rainwater is not stored, we will not have water for our daily needs after the rains. That means we have to store the rainwater. okay, we have to store the rainwater. We have to save the rainwater. To meet the whole year's need for water, rainwater must be stopped. That means rivers, we have to we have built the dam to stop the rainwater through the rivers, which is going and meeting to the sea. So sea water we can't use, it is not usable, so we have to construct the dams. When we stop the rainwater, it seeps into the soil. That means it percolates into the soil. So that percolated water we can use by digging well or bore well. That is groundwater we can use by digging well or bore well. Okay. As the groundwater storage increases, trees get water. Wells to get enough water and the lands can be cultivated. By using groundwater in famine condition, we can cultivate the land. So we have to store, we have to save the rainwater. How? By stopping the rainwater and allow it to percolate into the soil. Okay, because if we will not stop the rainwater, it meet to the river. By flowing, it meet to the river, then rivers go and meet to the sea, and sea water is we can't use for agriculture purpose. It is wastage. So we have to stop the rainwater. Several methods are used to make rainwater seep into the soil. How we can make rainwater seep into the soil? Large dams can be built. Across the rivers, dams we have to construct. But that may not be possible in all places. In that event, the government and the people come together to undertake several works, such as building smaller reservoirs, counter bundings, stopping the water of the smaller streams by constructing burns or bandharas, etc. See, one best example I'm going to tell, continuous counter trenches, CCT. Best example is whatever Amir Khan has started, that Shramadan. It is the best example. By Shramadan, all people came together with their wish and they construct the counter and stop the rainwater there, which seep in the soil and the water level in the ground is increased. In some places, wells are dug in river beds to allow water to collect in them. Rainwater falling on roofs of the houses is drained into large tanks placed beside the building. Using all such methods help us to store as much water as possible. See, we have bungalows and roof, rainwater falling on the roofs of houses must be collected in one tank, which is placed beside the building. In this way, we can save the rainwater and we can increase the water level in the ground. It is very important to use water carefully to stop rainwater from flowing away, to make it seep into the ground or to collect it in the tanks. We have to stop rainwater from flowing because we know it flow and goes to meet to the rivers, rivers meet to sea. The water is wasted there. So we have to allow the water to seep into ground or we have to collect the rainwater in the tanks. Taking steps to ensure that rainwater will be available even in the period after the rainy season is called water management. And how we manage, how we use the rainwater, how we ensure that rainwater will be available even in the period after the rainy season, it is called as water management. storing rainwater in tanks. In this picture, we can see that how rainwater is collected through the roofs of houses in the tank, making rainwater seep into the soil. Here we can see how the rainwater allowed to seep into the soil. Obtain information and discuss. What methods of water management are being used in your surroundings? You have to search in your colony what are the methods are used as a water management. Okay. Always remember, water is life. Use it judiciously. We have to use water properly. We don't have to waste the water. What we have learned? First one, when substances that are harmful for living things get mixed with water, it becomes polluted. Second, before wastewater is let into water bodies, it is processed in many ways to prevent their pollution. Wastewater we don't have to throw into water bodies before processes. First we have to process it, and then by processing it, we have to prevent the water pollution. Third, before the water is supplied to the public, the dissolved and undissolved substances in it are separated at the waterworks and the germs in it are destroyed. We have learned how we can separate the substances which are dissolved in water and which are undissolved in the water. And we use chlorine, we mix chlorine in the water to make it germs free. Fourth one, if it does not rain for a long time, it leads to drought and famine. Fifth one, famine conditions affect humans as well as animals and plants of that region. Sixth one, water management means stopping or storing water or letting it percolate into the ground to make it available even after the rainy season. It is called as water management. So students, in this way we will stop here. I will provide the answers of exercises. You have to copy it in your notebook and you have to complete the workbook. Thank you. Have a nice day. Stay home, stay safe, eat healthy, stay healthy and study well.